Ah, yes, new metal. So when it comes to genres out there that were popular during their time period but ultimately became irrelevant, new metal is definitely one of the more famous examples. A genre that once dominated the mainstream throughout the late 90s and early 2000s but ultimately lost popularity as the years went on. Not entirely, mind you, but there was certainly a decline. New metal was one of the more controversial and, yeah, hated genres out there. Along with other genres like post-crunch or even pop-punk, there were a lot of things to hate about new metal, especially on its time, for it being obnoxious, whiny, and in your face. Not all of new metal was bad, but a lot of bands, even some of the more popular bands, were pretty much the laughing stock for a lot of music communities out there. That said, there's no denying that this genre also saw some of the most popular acts during their prime. Linkin Park, Slipknot, Korn, Limp Bizkit, Evanescence, just to name a few. New metal was very much a dominant force, but that relevance also lasted for less than a decade, as around 2003 or so, it's when the genre started to fade away from the mainstream. But why is that? Is it because of other emerging genres? Were people getting too sick of new metal? Let's find out today. Now, of course, in order to figure out its fall, it's only fitting to talk about the genre's origins and how it became mainstream. New metal, by definition, is pretty much a genre that fuses metal with other groove centered genres like funk, rap, and even post-crunch. The origins of new metal can be found with alternative metal bands like Pantera or Faith No More that were not new metal but had aspects that would be more prominent in new metal acts, mainly their groove. However, it is often agreed that the first true new metal band out there was Korn, with their debut album being very commonly labeled as the first true new metal album. There are some genres out there where people tend to differ a lot on what they think was the first band of said genre. But when it comes to new metal, yeah, it pretty much started here. And the band themselves were popular from the very start as well. It's not the most popular the band has ever gotten, as that will be the case for a later album, but still, their debut did fairly well. It picked at number 72 on the Billboard 200, and on later years it will go on to eventually sell 10 million copies, which is nothing to sneeze at. After Korn's debut, some other acts will go on to appear as well. Both Deftones and Incubus debuted in 1995. Sepultura, well, released a new metal album in 1996. Limp Bizkit debuted in 1997. The genre, throughout just a few years, was developing into something that will take the mainstream soon. Not all of these new metal bands sound the same though. Deftones focus more on texture and atmosphere, for example, and Korn didn't integrate any rap to their music till 1998. Not sure if that was maybe the best idea, but you know. Speaking of 1998, an important year for the genre because it's the first year where new metal started to rage into the mainstream. And this is mainly because Korn released one song that will take them straight into the mainstream, Freakonalish. And it wasn't just a song that got popular, but the whole album will go on to peak at number 1 on the Billboard 200. System of a Down also debuted in that year, and although some of their more commercially successful songs will be on their next album, their debut did still manage to be certified gold. The wave of new metal popularity will continue in the following years as well. In 1999, Limp Bizkit released Significant Other, which is their breakthrough to the mainstream, with a lot of their most popular songs like Nookie or Break Stuff. Korn released Issues, which is also very successful, and had Running Away From Me, which is one of their most popular songs. Oh, and there was Slipknot's debut as well. New metal was certainly becoming very popular. Now, when it comes to the popular mainstream new metal bands by that point, was it all good? No. Limp Bizkit, even on the older albums when they were at their peak of their popularity, I think they've always sucked. One of the main features of new metal was its use of rap, and I think Limp Bizkit represented just how obnoxious rapping in new metal can be, probably more than any other new metal band that I can think of, at the very least from the mainstream. Fred Durst is also just a straight up annoying frontman, and a lot of the production doesn't also really flare with me. I mean, for the longest time, Limp Bizkit was the biggest laughingstock when it came to new metal, and I think it's very easy to see why. Also, I was never really a big fan of Korn, but that's a different discussion. Still though, I do have a soft spot for some of the other music from new metal. I like plenty of stuff from Slipknot's debut. I mean, that album had Wait and Bleed, Eyeless, Sick, Spit It Out, just plenty of some of my favorite songs from Slipknot. System of a Down I've always liked as well, and Deftones was certainly one of the more unique acts out there. However, new metal wouldn't actually reach its peak until the year 2000. New metal had already experienced a lot of mainstream success with bands like Korn or Limp Bizkit, but the most popular new metal band was Linkin Park. They released Hybrid Theory, their debut, on October 24th, and let me tell you, this album was massive. 27 million copies sold. Yeah, this album was definitely Diamond Certified and had In The End, which is not only one of the most popular new metal songs out there, but it's one of the most popular songs from the 21st century. Oh yeah, it was that big. And yeah, the other singles from the album were also very popular. Linkin Park were a band that had a lot of appeal. They had a commercial sound, but they also were unique in the new metal sphere, integrating industrial and electronic elements while still keeping that new metal flair that brought a lot of people back in the day. It's also one of my favorite albums from this genre. Like, maybe I'm a little biased because this was the first album that I've ever heard in full. Like, ever. Yeah, Linkin Park was a band that I've listened to a lot when I was a teenager, and I still like them, even if I wouldn't consider them one of my favorite bands anymore. But I used to listen to this album and the following album that I'll be talking about later a lot back in the day. Paper Cut, Points of Authority, In The End, A Place For My Head, Pushing Me Away. This album had a lot of bangers, and considering just how wide the band's sound was, not only appealing to people who like new metal, but also a lot of rock fans in general, it's quite easy to tell why the album became as popular as it did. Oh, and I guess there was also Disturbed. But even after the highest peak of new metal, several other popular new metal albums were also very prominent during the early 2000s. There was the follow-up to Significant Other, that being Chocolate Starfish and the Hot Dog Flavor Water, which is one of the worst titles and album covers probably in music history. But hey, the album had Rollin'. Tell me what you gonna do now. Yeah, this album, despite being less well received than Significant Other, was still a commercial success and brought Limp Bizkit a lot of popularity. I never listened to it, I don't know, it's probably bad. I mean, look at that album cover, Jesus. 2001 also had some remembered new metal records as well. There was Toxicity, which is System of a Down's most well-known album to date, with some classics like Chop Suey, Toxicity, and Aerials. It's also one of the very few albums in the genre that still has a good reputation to this day. The album is known to be a classic. There was also the second Slipknot album, Iowa. Even though I do like their self-titled more, this album still had a lot of things that, well, I like from Slipknot. And Iowa is also an even more angry and ferocious album than their self-title. I mean, just by listening to this song. Everybody hates me now, so fucking bullets on my face and my hands, and I don't know why. I'm not afraid to cry, but that's none of your business. Yeah, you kind of get the idea. Great song, by the way. 2002 had Untouchables by Korn. Honestly, I don't care for this album, but you could still make the argument that this was the last relevant Korn album, because it does have one of their most well-liked songs, that one being Here to Stay. And 2003 had Meteora and Fallen. Meteora was the follow-up to Hybrid Theory, and it was a big commercial success. It didn't sell as well as Hybrid Theory, but I mean, considering the insane numbers of that album, that's kind of understandable. Meteora also had its share of classics too, like Fame, Numb, and my personal favorite, and probably my favorite Linkin Park song, being Breaking the Habit. The song is not really a new metal song, if anything it's a bit of a departure from the rest of the album, since it leans more into alternative rock, but it deserves a mention because the song is really great. Despite being a different song in sound, the song not only has a lot of the band's common qualities, but the melodic atmosphere and the dark lyrics of the song is just incredible. And then Fallen was Evanescence's debut, and far and away their most successful album. It's fine, I guess. It's very much a singles album, and even when it comes to the singles, I'm honestly kind of mixed on. You have Going Under and My Immortal, which are okay songs, and Bring Me to Life is Bring Me to Life. Wake me up! Wake me up inside! I can't wake up! Wake me up inside! But nu metal from 1998 to the beginning of 2003 was pretty much at its peak of its popularity, with a lot of songs dominating the charts and a lot of albums selling a lot of copies. But with all of the mainstream success came along a lot of criticism as well. Like I said before, a lot of people didn't like how obnoxious and whiny the genre was, how even commercial the genre was at all. Sure, there was some good stuff, but for every Linkin Park and Deftones, there was also a Limp Bizkit and a Papa Roach and a Godsmack. Oh god, Godsmack was probably the worst out of all of them. There were even bands that didn't like to be associated with the genre. And to an extent, all of the hate that nu metal got, you could say it's part of the reason why the genre started to fall off later on. Just like a lot of other genres out there, nu metal's popularity ultimately didn't last very long. 2003 was kind of the turning point for the genre. I've mentioned that there were some relevant and popular albums from 2003, but this was also arguably the start of the downfall for nu metal. As to why nu metal started to fall off, I have three main reasons as to why I think that's the case. Let's start with the genre's reputation. A lot of trends out there follow a simple fate. They begin, they get a sure amount of time to be popular because of their broad appeal, and then they disappear. And nu metal kind of falls into this fate as well. I mean, yeah, a lot of people these days have their fond memories with a lot of nu metal bands, and some of these bands still have a strong fanbase to this day. But the reality is that most nu metal bands out there, even most nu metal bands that became popular, simply just didn't have a lasting impact on culture. Sure, you remember bands like Linkin Park or Slipknot, but are you really going to tell me that Tap Rot or Motograder are some of the most essential rock bands of the 2000s? I don't think so. There was also the rise of other genres slash decreasing popularity of rock. Now, rock throughout the mid-2000s was still fairly popular. You had Green Day's American Idiot, you had Gorillaz, you had The Killers. Heck, even Nickelback, as much of a laughing stock as they were, they did largely dominate the charts. I mean, How You Remind Me is the highest charting rock song of the decade. But I mean, still, compared to previous decades, rock was noticeably less popular, and a large amount of what was popular in the mainstream during the decade, especially as the decade went on, was far more focused on pop, R&B, rap, and adult contemporary. And rock was even less relevant during the 2010s, which by that point, it wasn't even mainstream anymore. But I think the most clear reason as to why nu metal went through such a downfall was because nearly every big nu metal act either became irrelevant or changed their sound completely, or pretty much both. You had Linkin Park, which departed from their nu metal sound in their third album, Minutes to Midnight, which was far more alternative rock than it was nu metal. Slipknot was still somewhat nu metal in their third album, but it was a lot more alternative metal than their self-titled in Iowa. Korn had a nu metal album in 2003, but it was a lot less commercially successful and even less well-received than everything that they've released prior, which led to them changing their sound in 2005. Evanescence was still Evanescence by their second album in 2006, but that album was far less commercially successful than their debut. And then there's Limp Bizkit. Oh man, Limp Bizkit. After Chocolate Starfish, the band's guitarist left and was replaced by, well, a worse guitarist. They released Results May Vary in 2003, an album that despite having some of those traits of what came before, was also softer and more acoustic. In other words, they were trying to be more emotional with this album, with even a cover from The Who's Behind Blue Eyes. The album was not only very poorly received, but it sold less than their previous albums, and it's often considered to be the band's worst album. Which, you know, for a band that wasn't even good during their peak, that's definitely a low. I mean, to be honest, the album deserves the reputation that it has because it is honestly quite awful, and their cover for Behind Blue Eyes is honestly one of the worst covers out there. The band after the album disappeared for like 8 years until returning with Cold Cobra in 2011, an album that despite them trying to go back to their roots, it was just too little too late. So nu metal, with all of those reasons in mind, naturally just became a genre of its time. A lot of these nu metal acts are still relevant, people to this day still remember bands like Korn, Slipknot, and Linkin Park, and in a way the genre had some influence with a lot of deathcore and metalcore bands from the 2010s. But yeah, the matter of the fact is, nu metal just isn't as popular as it used to be.